Australia's agricultural sector is on high alert for foot and mouth disease.
If you think foot and mouth disease won't affect you, think again. If the virus makes its way here, it could rip the heart of the nation's economy and even stop you from buying meat at the supermarket. Put simply, FMD is one of the most contagious animal diseases and is the single biggest threat to Australia's livestock industries.
An outbreak in Indonesia is threatening to cripple their industry, and there's serious concern the devastating disease could break out here. Now, if that were to happen, the results would be far-reaching and catastrophic and could result in more than $80 billion in damage. So, what is it and how do we avoid an outbreak here in Australia? Foot and mouth disease, or FMD, is a serious and highly contagious animal disease that affects all cloven-hoofed animals, including cattle, sheep, goats, camels, deer, and pigs. Cloven-hoofed animals are those with divided hooves. It does not affect horses or zebras. FMD is a disease of animals, not humans, and is a different disease than hand, foot and mouth disease, which is common in young children. Foot and mouth disease is not transmitted to humans by eating affected meat. The virus is carried by live animals and in meat and dairy products, as well as in soil, bones, untreated hides, and vehicles and equipment used with these animals. It can also be carried on people's clothing and footwear and survives in frozen, chilled, and freeze-dried foods. In May 2022, an outbreak of foot and mouth disease was reported in cattle in Indonesia and has since spread to barley. Now, an incursion of the virus would have severe consequences for Australia's animal health and trade. The emergence and rapid spread of foot and mouth disease in Indonesia has changed the risk profile for passengers and goods arriving in Australia from there. So, as a result, we've strengthened our border activities and new measures were immediately imposed to help prevent an outbreak. Travellers arriving from Indonesia will be under much stricter biosecurity scrutiny, including those from the popular tourist destination of Bali. The Albanese government last month announced a $14 million biosecurity package. It's also rolled out biosecurity dogs at Darwin and Cairns airports, as well as sanitation and on-ground support at Australian and international airports. Now, these measures might be annoying if you're travelling home from Bali, but it's a small price to pay to save an entire Australian industry. So, be prepared to have your shoes wiped, and please don't try and bring Macca's breakfast on the plane home from Denpasar.